Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to create shortcuts to your Microsoft Edge profiles in Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to create shortcuts of your profiles in Microsoft Edge, I'm going to show you how to do that. And you just need to follow these instructions. So if I click on my profile icon here in Microsoft Edge, you can see that I have three different profiles here. Currently signed into one, and then I have two additional profiles. Now to create shortcuts to these profiles, if you have a look at the taskbar down here, you can see that these Microsoft Edge icons down here all have different profile icons. So to create a shortcut, you can open up Microsoft Edge in the profile that you want to create the shortcut for. Then you can right click on the icon in your taskbar, and then you can click on pin to taskbar. So if I close Microsoft Edge completely, and I want to open up this profile with the coffee cup. If I click on that, it'll open this profile. Now, if I go ahead and open up this shortcut, it's going to open one of my other accounts. As you can see, the picture changed up there. Now, to get these shortcuts on your desktop instead of the normal Microsoft Edge shortcut, first, just make sure that you do have a shortcut of Microsoft Edge on your desktop. If you don't have one, just open a new File Explorer window, then navigate to Local Disk C, then Program Files x86, then you want to find Microsoft, Edge, Application, and then you'll find this msedge.exe file, and you can right click on this, then go to Send To, and then click on Desktop, Create Shortcut, because you need to have a shortcut for Microsoft Edge on the desktop for every profile that you want to create a shortcut for. So in this example, we're just going to use this shortcut. But once you have your Edge profiles down here on the taskbar, if you want to add it as a desktop shortcut as well, you can right click on this icon in the taskbar, then go to the Edge shortcut with your profile's name, right click on it, then click on Properties, and it's going to open up this window. Now in this Microsoft Edge file path, you can see that there's some flags here to launch a specific profile. So to make this easy, just click anywhere inside of this target box, then press Ctrl and A on your keyboard so you can select all of this text, right click on it, then click on copy, and then click on OK. Now go to the desktop shortcut that you created, right click on it, then click on properties, and you're going to get to this window again, or basically the same type of window, and the target year should be selected by default. Just click on delete, so you can get rid of all of that. Then right click here and click on paste. And then you should have the same target as before with this flag included. You can click on apply and OK. Now you can also right click on the shortcut, then click on rename. So you can change the name to whichever profile it's going to launch. In my case, the profile is called recording. So if I go ahead and double click on this, it's going to open the recording profile that I have in Microsoft Edge. Now, real quick, just to recap, if I want to add this profile that I also have pinned it down here in the taskbar, I'll need to have a shortcut for Microsoft Edge on the desktop. I'll need to right click on the icon in the taskbar, then right click here on this Microsoft Edge shortcut, click on properties, then this target will be selected by default. Right click on that, click on copy, then click on OK to close this window, then go to the desktop shortcut, right click on it, click on properties, and in this window you can just press backspace or delete to get rid of that target, then right click again and click on paste, then click on apply and OK. And again, you can change the name of this. I'll just call this personal, and then if I double click on this, it's going to launch my personal profile, and if I double click on this shortcut, it's going to launch my recording profile. So that's how you can add shortcuts to your profiles in Microsoft Edge, and I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video, and I'll see you in the next one.